All right, so I got access to Microsoft Designer, Microsoft's new AI-powered design tool that I think is meant to compete with tools like probably Canva and other similar tools. So, got access to it here. We're gonna open it up, check it out, see what we think of it. I'm gonna give my honest thoughts, feedback. Who is it for, who's it not for? And we're gonna see. So here we go, we got Designer by Microsoft. Looks like, you know what? Cool, fancy video, sweet. So it's never been easier to approach a blank canvas. So you start with a description of a simple idea, so some text, and then you can add your own image or you can generate an image using description, using AI. Create one-of-a-kind images for your designs, so a grumpy koala bear or a party as a clay sculpture. Okay, using DALL-E 2. So Microsoft is leveraging its connection with DALL-E to create generative AI art. Get the inspiration you're looking for. Add or remove content, okay. So let's see here. We got to describe a design you'd like to create. Let's just try something here. An Instagram post about joining my free community for professional web designers, not just professional designers and freelancers called Creative X Crew. Links in the description below. Join up right now and let's continue the discussion about the intersection of design, creativity, and building a creative business in the wake of AI and all this crazy technology that's around us. Links down below. Generate. See what we got. Okay. Let's see what we got here. So first of all, I'm impressed that, you know, it can generate the text. It's kind of cool. I can change the orientation. Interesting. So this is an Instagram post, so they're going square. None of these so far are on brand, and that makes sense because it doesn't have my brand assets and brand colors and logos. But if you're just trying to create something, sure. Maybe the one that is the most interesting to me would be something like this one. Well, let's try a new one. A motion Instagram story about my weekly live office hours in the Creative X Crew. Can I do like commas? Like purple, pink, people, community. I don't know. This might not work well. I'm curious. Not too bad, actually. I feel like there's some of these I could probably work with. And it's using motion. That's cool. The windmills, you know, and the dad carrying the sun is not quite like on brand. Again, I don't know what to expect here or what I'm expecting. This is kind of neat. I could be like, join office hours every week. You know, it's like, and it shows like, there's lots of people who come to office hours. You should be one of them. What if I like clicked this one and customized design? What can I do? I change the color. So the color here needs to be more on brand. So I'll click this one. Oh, it gives me different ideas based on, oh, that's pretty cool. What if I changed it to this one? That's kind of cool. What if I changed the text? Can I change the text? What font options do I have? Okay, so brand font? Oh, can I upload my own font? You can create a brand kit. Okay, so that's pretty cool. I'm pretty impressed by that. That's pretty much like Canva lets you do a brand hub or a brand kit, and you can do your fonts, you can do your images, colors, and these things. I mean, so yeah, I get the idea here. I'm not like super shocked or amazed at, you know, this graphic per se, but what I think is cool is that you can create designs based on just prompts to get something started. So if you have something you're trying to create, you know, a promo, an Instagram promo, maybe you're sending out an email newsletter, like, you know, and you want a header to that email graphic, you know, marketing, and design collateral for a campaign you're working on. You need something quick. You need maybe a carousel style image or post or layout. I feel like you can really, you know, kind of work with it, you know, and it gives you prompts here to play with. Kind of like this one, because every week in the Creative X Crew on Mondays, we do an event called Coffee, Co-Work, and Chill. We're just going to hang out, turn on our cameras. We just work, listen to music. We just chat. And so it's pretty casual. And so this is kind of neat. You know, I would change the text. So basically it's just given me like just kind of something to to work with. And because it's kind of, it's animated, like, you know, I can choose something like this. I can make like a holding graphic, like when we go live and my camera's not on yet, I can get it to generate like a, you know, maybe I should try it. Some sort of like holding screen for like a line drawing of coffee, you know, cup with the steam coming out of it. Or yeah, maybe I should try that. So it gave me the animated line drawing here. Pretty basic, but it's giving me an Instagram story orientation, but I want it to be landscape. So let's try that. Yeah, I'm kind of into this. Coffee, co-work, and chill. You know, and I can maybe replace this image with one that I've already photographed that's on brand for the community. Well, I'm pretty impressed. So it's like, I see the utility and the usefulness of this. It's kind of like, for me, what I'm understanding here is it seems like this is a direct competitor to Canva. Now, I'm noticing with Canva that Canva also has AI starting to become integrated within the tool, within the software, for similar things like create this graphic, generate this type of art, and it plays around with the AI, you know, to create the graphic or the art, and it comes up with a layout for you. And I think it even allows you to use AI to help come up with text, different wording. But Microsoft Designer seems like it's a pretty cool tool. I'm probably not quite going to use it for what I'm doing. I've been using Canva to create YouTube thumbnails, graphics for the Creative X crew within the community. There's lots of events that are happening, posts, things like that, where I just kind of need to whip something together. I like having access to the brand hub where I can assign, you know, my brand hub to my team members who help design graphics for me, and they can only stick within the constraints of the brand kit that's established. Seems like Microsoft Designer has a similar thing set up. So if you're used to the Microsoft, you know, product suite, and you're a Microsoft person and you like that, you know, how they do things, then this is going to be pretty familiar and probably going to be a nice welcome change for you. But if you're an Adobe user and you use Adobe's tools, you know, or you like Figma, or heck, you maybe even like Canva. I don't know if you'd necessarily switch over, but I think that we've got a pretty cool tool here that it's got some pretty serious leverage in the AI department, because Microsoft and OpenAI are like two peas in a pod. So they've got access to some of the best AI that I'm aware of. So at first pass, I'm pretty impressed. I think it's a cool tool. Will I just switch over to it? No, I don't think so. It's not compelling enough for me to do so, but to try it out and play around with it, I'm pretty impressed. You might want to check it out. Go to designer.microsoft.com and sign up for the waitlist and see if you can get access to it. It only took me a couple days to get access to it, and then here I am playing around with it. So try that out. More importantly, join us in the Creative X crew. It's my free community for professional designers and freelancers, or aspiring designers and freelancers who want to succeed at their craft and make a career doing work that they love. We talk about design, we give you design feedback, we help you get clients, we help partner you up with people in the community. These are people that you can network with, that you can collaborate with, your potential vendors and partners. Come learn a few things, hang out with us. We do weekly events, we do workshops, trainings. It's all free, all thanks to Editor X. So down in the link description below, there's a link for the Creative X crew. Also in the pinned comment, I welcome you to come and join us. And until next time, I'll see you in another video. Cheers.